Hello everyone. I hope you are doing good. And Tekken Foray is there with another video to clear your practical concepts. So here in this video, I'll show you how to create a load balancer and balance the loads on different instances. So I hope you have you remember in my previous video we created Linux and Windows instances with web server on that. So in this video, what we do is we already have Windows and Linux instance in our web server, in our demo VPC and public subnet. So in this, we will create a target group for load balancer, where load balancer will shift the traffic and add those Windows instance and Linux instance in the target group and create a load balancer. Then we will access the web pages that is installed on Windows server and Linux instance using load balancer DNS. So load balancer will start diverting the traffic on these instances like this. So once we are done with this, then we will, just for testing purpose, what we can do is we will stop one instance on which existing traffic is going, and then automatically load balancer will shift the traffic on another instance. So let me go to the diagram for more clarity to show you. So I hope you remember this diagram that we created in our previous, used the same diagram in our previous practical videos. We created network layer, compute layer, and we have public subnet, private subnet. These are the routing tables and security groups, public and private security groups. So you can watch previous videos to how to create all these different components. In this video, what we are going to do is we have existing Windows instance, Linux instance with web server installed it. And in this video, we will create a network load balancer and balance the traffic on these instances for their web traffic. So this is also another industrial use case where load balancer is used for segregating, for sending the traffic on a group of instances or group of web servers. So we can say this is our web layer, as we discussed our use cases in our while discussing the AWS security architectures. So there we have seen that this is one of the way using deploying application using network load balancer. So let's log into our web console and create a load balancer. So here we already have, as I described, I created a Windows instance and public instance. So here and web server is already running, and we tested this in our previous video. So in detail, if you want to check how to create a Windows instance, Linux instance, installing web server on these, so you can check those previous videos. So without wasting time, let's get into load balancer practical. So let's go to VPC. So we are into in North Virginia using our username Tekken4a at zadmin. So zadmin is a user in Tekken4a. So let's go to load balancer. So here we are into our console. This is our VPC. Let's go to EC2 instances for creating a load balancer and target group, as I shown you in the diagram. So here is load balancing group. So let's go to target group and create the target group and add those instances in it. So click on create target group. We are creating the target type instances. Target group is demo target group. So protocol we are going to use TCP. and our own demo VPC. Health check, we are going to use HTTP. And this is the way how it is going to check the health. So here are some more health checking settings. Let's keep default for the time being. And if you want to see all those theoretical concepts, you need to go to our AWS Cloud course. And there you can see how all these things working in theoretically. So here I am covering practical concepts only. So click on next. So here are instances that we created. Let's choose these public instances on which we have enabled web server, include them into our target group. So create target group. So this is our target group, and this for the time being it is showing as unused. So let's create a load balancer. So click on create load balancer. We are going to use network load balancer, create demo LB internet facing, and select a VPC, our demo VPC, and the US East region. It is accepting on 80 port, TCP 80, select our target group, demo target group. We have added the listener on which traffic will be, on which load balancer will throw the traffic. So these are the default things, tags. We can add tag, department, network. Okay, create load balancer. Okay, we need to select this public subnet, create load balancer. So click on view load balancers. So this will take some time. It's provisioning, and this is the DNS name that is generated for this load balancer. So we will use this DNS name to access the web servers that are installed, web pages that are installed on the instances, and this is internet facing. So this will take some time. So for the time being, I'll pause this video. Okay, so you can see that our load balancer is ready and it's active state. So if we go to our target group, demo target group, so you can see our both the instances are healthy, and load balancer has performed the health check on both these instances, and this is healthy. So now if we go to our load balancer and copy the DNS name, and let's go to our Explorer. So if we paste our DNS name for load balancer. So now we can see to which instance it is throwing the traffic. Yeah, so it is throwing the traffic on Windows instance. So now what we can do is now you can see that we are accessing the web pages of those Windows instances through the load balancer. I'll show you on the diagram. So these are our web servers. These are our web servers. First, we were accessing these web servers using their own public IPs. Now we have placed load balancer before these instances, and we are accessing these web pages using this load balancer. So I hope this clarifies the concept. So now what we are going to do is, so now the traffic is going towards a Windows instance. We will stop this instance. Automatically traffic will move towards this instance. Let's go to our console and do that. So this is going towards Windows instance. Let's go to our console. Let's go to instances, EC2 instance. Let's stop our Windows public instance. And it will show unhealthy in the target group once we stop it. But it will take some time because there are some settings in the health check system. So stop this instance, stop. So it is getting stopped. So in if we go to our target group, there we can see this, the state will start changing after some time. So now health check takes some time. We have defined these settings. So we have stopped the Windows server. So if we go to our load balancer, so if we refresh it, so this will throw the traffic on Linux instance. See, this is a test page on Linux instance. So I hope you understand the concept. Now automatically web server, Windows web server is stopped and traffic is going on Linux web server. So this we have shown an automatic failover of the traffic. If one instance goes down or something wrong happens on one instance, automatically another instance is ready to take the traffic. So this is a concept of load balancing. And if we go over here, so this after some time, this will turn, our Windows instance will turn unhealthy. Let's refresh it. Yeah, so now you can see that our Windows public instance is unhealthy because we have stopped it, or maybe in real scenario, there could something wrong happens on the web server, it goes unhealthy and traffic is going to Linux instance. So that was all for this video. Our main objective was to show the working of load balancing the traffic to different instances. So thank you for watching the videos. In case you have any questions, queries, or doubts, do contact us on website techinfore.com. Thank you very much.